Listen, I just came in from outside, so I know. I know what's popping and I know what's not. Maybe where she lives, everybody's trying to be skinny. But where I live, what I have is where it's at, okay? And I was so glad to come back to America because this girl, this woman in China, I went to this restaurant one day and I told you they'd be asking dumbass questions. This girl in China asked me, do men like my butt? And I was like, yo, men like my butt. This lady at the mall asked me one day in Chinese why my butt was so big. She walked up to me. She had to be about 132 years old. This little Chinese lady walked up to me and asked me why my butt was so big. Where's your mommy, the pingo? Where's your mom? Dasha, pingo. I said, because I'm a woman. Well, shared not in. I'm a woman. Not in. You in. Naren is man. I'm a woman, nigga. I wonder why your husband is in love with you because you look like you're 10. You better ask your granddaughters. But does she not know this doesn't look good? Like, I've seen this video before, and I'm wondering, I'm sure by now she knows that we don't think it looks good. And I know a lot of people have a body dysmorphia, but it doesn't usually go the other way. Well, no, there are people that think they look a lot better than they do. I might be one of them. Shit. But listen. I guess she said it's paid for. But I guess she had an irremarkable body before because nobody ever talked about it. But I don't remember anyone ever saying it looked bad. And when she put them pants on and they got caught right around here. Oh, when she jumped, she thought that was because she's thick now. She didn't realize it got caught on them hooks. I'm not trying to throw shade. I'm just being real.
A lot of body dysmorphia for a lot of people. And it's like costing a lot of people, like mentally and spiritually. A lot of girls that get the BBLs, they don't, it's never like a first round. It's like either two or three rounds until it's like perfected. So yeah, you just have to understand what you're signing up for. And I added in some BBL clips that do look good. Like this one right here. Yes, this looks good. Yeah.
That's a more natural look. That's a much more natural look.
And this one.
What the fuck? She said that's her BBL. Oh, okay. I was gonna say that does look better. Yeah,
looks really natural.
That definitely.
Yes, looks really natural. So do I think that BBLs are going out of style? No, but I do feel like the natural looking more BBLs or just the natural look period is just coming back in.
But this next story that we're going to get into is about a young lady. This is she's telling a story of her friend. Her friend got a BBL surgery done. And
I don't have no notes. Hey, Jonathan. You know what? I saw some girls in China. There is a whole WeChat group where girls trade information on how to buy clothes. In China, I'm a 5X. That's my size. 5X. But I saw some women. I mean, my little brother married a big girl. She's gorgeous too. I can't stand her, but she's pretty. she know I can't stand her ass. She got that Chinese attitude. She thinks she's better than me and everybody else who ain't white. But she's a big girl, and she's a big girl. Like, she's big. And there are not a lot, but you find that the way they get treated is absolutely horrible. Like, I've seen black women who are big women go to China and get treated so bad that they go back home. You ain't gonna see it. It's not acceptable. It's not, I see little girls sitting eat a table full of food. You ain't gonna eat in public if you big in China, unless you're a man. When I was in China, they said I looked strong. You look strong. That's what men would tell me. You look very strong. Yeah, I could take you. Don't try it. Have you ever been to China, Jonathan? Help me remember. I don't remember. if you ever had been, or if you live anywhere with a Chinatown, but size there is everything. Skin complexion and size. They are very aesthetically hyper-focused. But I don't have any notes on this, on what we just saw. That's my sound. That's Shakira, right? That's my girl. I'm gonna tell you something Shakira said that I'll never forget. Shakira, who I honestly believe is probably the Bruja of the entertainment industry. I'm not trying to put her business out there. I just feel like she is a person people go to get work done. She got that energy about her. And she has a quote where she says, "Nothing beautiful comes without sacrifice." So don't ever forget that. That's the law of compensation. Oh, yes, right. You're in the Mississippi Gulf in Biloxi. Am I right? Oh, okay. Yeah, there's sections of them everywhere. Oh, Lord. All right, let me get back over here.
And got it done by, like I said, you got to do your research. A doctor that was a box doctor and he harvests organs and stuff. After she got her surgery done, her body was like off and stuff like that. They did a scan on her and found out that one of her kidneys was missing. So let's get into it.
Goes to DR, right? She gets the surgery done. She had lipo and she had a tummy tuck. And then she has a physical, right? But since then, she was complaining. She was complaining of just body aches, headaches, you know, just feeling really heavy all the time. So she went to the doctor. And the doctor tells her, "Hey, we just got your blood results. Why is your kidney count low?" So then the doctor says, "Have you had any surgeries? Have you had any surgeries in the last year?" "Yes, I've had tummy tuck, I've had BBL, all of these things." So she has a CAT scan on. And during a CAT scan, it shows up she only has one kidney. So down in DR, this botch organ selling doctor took one of her kidneys. She thought she was getting the steal of her life. She was like, $3,500 for all that? Yeah, sign me up. Little did she know that the doctor was actually selling her kidney. I don't know how much kidneys go on the black market, but I know it's way more than $3,500.
Now here's where we get into the ghetto element. I always say that when women or men live a certain lifestyle, have a certain mentality, and operate a certain way that is more low life than high life, they find themselves in these kind of situations. No, I'm not blaming the victim. I don't even know if this is a true story. She ain't said yet who this friend is, how she know this person, and why this person ain't telling their own story. So for all we know, this is completely made up. But I do know that when you go trying to get something cheap or free, this how the fuck it's gonna turn out. Do not we see that over and over again? Do not we see niggas invest $500 to Jay Morrison and find out that money is gone? Because you're not gonna invest $500 in nothing and get nothing. More than like $3, if that. That's good. Do we not see these people go to these veneer techs thinking they're going to get the top and the bottom for $1,500 and come out with infections and all type of shit? Do we not see this situation over and over again where people, now Jackie O paid $8,000 for her breast augmentation. She paid almost nothing, if I understand correctly, for the surgery where she died. And she had another surgery right before that within the last year. And the doctor told her, "You probably shouldn't have this surgery because you just had a breast augmentation a year ago." And she's like, "Nah, I'm good. Let's go." She had three surgeries in less than like 4 years. And paid less and less and less for them every time because her celebrity was getting her promotion deals. And it ended up costing her her life and that of her children for the most part. So we got to keep that in mind. You ain't going to get nothing for free. If it don't cost, it ain't for you. You have to live your life at a certain standard and have a certain... See, and here we go talking about street niggas again. I just saw something earlier today. I saw something that came across my desk where there's a concept in some countries where store owners leave their books outside at night. so that their stores don't get robbed. And the thinking is that people who read don't steal, and people who steal don't read. You know, so like what you're willing to invest in is what's going to pay off the most. And if you're not willing to invest in your own body and getting things done the right way, I mean, her friend paid $3,500. Do you know how much a kidney goes for? Like what, $20,000? They be taking niggas' thyroids. They be taking all type of shit. I don't think you're gonna get a good breast job nowadays. I don't know. I ain't priced one in decades, but I don't think you're gonna get a really good breast job now for less than $7,000. What would make anybody think they're gonna get, she said, a tummy tuck, a BBL, and all that. So most likely it was a tummy tuck, a BBL. She probably got some fat taken off of her shanks in the back so that it all makes sense. She probably had a little bit of thigh surgery done. I mean, I guarantee you, she had a whole lot of, it was a major surgery. It was a lot of anesthesia. It was a whole lot of bullshit. And she thought everything was okay. What's up, Burgundy? She thought everything was okay. And now she ain't got no kidneys. Kidney. For what? And I guarantee you, well, I can't guarantee you that, because a whole lot of women do this because it does add money to their pocket. They're strippers or models or some type of something where they feel like their body is going to add to their income. But in a lot of these situations, what that lady was talking about earlier, where she said these grandmas, why the fuck was Kanye West's mama getting goddamn surgery? What the fuck for? Don't nobody even know you. That man pays your bills. You don't have to get surgery. For what? For the fuck what? And then you saw on Love and Hip Hop Hollywood, Lyrica Anderson asked her son-in-law for liposuction for her birthday. She's like 70. 70, and she's beautiful. Let's put that on the record. Gorgeous woman. But she lives in California. California got a different standard of beauty. I told y'all Dalton women that. Don't take that Midwest body out here to the Midwest and think you're going to be rocking. Hell no. Hell no. She had to compete, unfortunately, with women half her age and with half her waistline for everything. You know? So it's really weird. I was really watching my mama very closely. My mother was very careful. I told you, my mother was damn near obsessed with making sure she was thin. That just was her personality. She's a Capricorn, y'all know. And I would watch her, make sure, mama, you ain't getting no surgery, are you? No, girl, you know, I count my calories. I go on my walks. You know, I stop eating at 7. I drink my lemon water every day. Baby, you know, I know what to do. I ain't laying on no doctor's table. But her friends sure were getting them damn surgeries in Riverside and shit. Looking snatched, baby.
Now she's trying to contact this doctor. Now she's trying to find out, okay, where is this doctor? This doctor disappeared, guys. Disappeared. The girl that was on freaking IG, come to find out, that girl was not even real. That girl was not even a real person.
Oh, my God. See, she used to doing hood shit. I'm going to call it like it motherfucking is. I guarantee you, she used to doing hood shit. She probably paid cash for some shit that we wouldn't normally pay cash for. She probably do a whole lot of shit that's under the table. You good? Yeah. You need some milk? Yeah. You want to get it out the refrigerator, or you want me to get it for you? Okay. She used to doing, I'm keeping my eye out though. She used to doing shit a real low life kind of way. How did she not know? The question that you asked, Ted, comes from a man who I'm going to assume has some sort of education. Because she don't know. First of all, kidneys are back here. So wouldn't that mark, that incision, be on her back? If I understand correctly, you have to tell me. But she might not have even paid any attention. She might not, that whatever that is, that scar might have been really good. You never know. I mean, she might not have paid attention. she might not have known. She might have had other complications that kind of took precedence over that, and she never really front or side. Okay, because I know I had a brother with real bad kidney issues in college, a play brother, and he was always rubbing his back. So I'm just assuming the kidneys are in the back. Thank you. All right, y'all. Let me see. Let me continue with this. I'm smiling because I love when y'all get Burgundy Love when she comes over here. Thank you for doing that. I love it. I just presume Burgundy Blue commentary that living in Dalton or so close to Dalton, you deal with a whole lot of bullshit on a regular basis. So I love that our channel is a place you can come over and get some love because we got it for you, baby. We got it for you, baby.
That girl was a botch account, fake ass account, and that account was actually taken down. It was shown that this girl that was like, oh yeah, my body this, and look at this doctor did this type of a job on me. All those pictures were taken off of Google. Those were Google stole pictures. So that wasn't even a real person, okay? So yeah. Now my friend is pretty much like, oh my
god. Your friend didn't go on a website and research? Oh. I know because I studied my demographics. I know that I'm talking to people who are like, where did she find out about this person from then? Do you realize y'all 50, not in there, baby, in that box right there. Do you realize, I almost said y'all's ages. I guess I'm not supposed to. Yeah, just throw the whole thing away. Not the spoon, just the bowl. All right. I'm gonna say y'all's ages. I guess I'm not supposed to. Do y'all realize there are people who find their veneer techs and BBL surgeons and lash techs on Instagram and Snapchat? And that's the extent. That's how far it goes. It don't go to no website. It don't go to no Better Business, blah, blah, blah. It don't go to no research. It's an Instagram, what's the price? Can I fly there? Can somebody take care of my kids? Ooh, they smoking something. Ooh. I got distracted, my mouth started watering. It's dinner time in my neighborhood and the restaurant over the way is smoking something. But anyway, sorry about that. It's a squirrel, but yeah, there's no website. There's no business card. There's no consultation. There's no phone call with a receptionist that answers the phone and can give you access to a website that vouches for this doctor. Like, it just feels like it's the low life of it. It's the low expectations. And when us nerds, we research everything. And they call us nerds, but we don't fall into these situations. We don't get scammed by street niggas. Ain't nobody stealing our kidneys. But these cool kids sure do get scammed a lot. These cool kids who are too cool to read and do research.
I can't find a doctor. I don't know exactly what the hell I'm gonna do. And now she has one kidney. Now she has one kidney and she's going through a whole bunch of freaking crap. Now she has to take medication. Now she has to do all these things. And now she really has to protect her one kidney.
And you see, look at that. Her friend went in for one thing and left out with multiple health problems because your kidneys are very important. Because if they took both of her kidneys, then it just, like, that would have been a whole different ballpark because when both of your kidneys is not working, then you have to go on dialysis and that's a whole nother ballpark. So that is messed up. And then on top of that, now she can't find the person. That's why I said it's very... be very vigilant on like doing your research. That's why I said I don't knock you getting a surgery, but don't just jump in head first. Like, I feel like you should do at least a hardcore 6 months to a year of like research. And like she was saying, they do have those Facebook groups, they have Instagram groups where like girlies are giving like jewels on what you should do, like the proper like way to get a BBL, of like getting the procedure done and knowing that you have to like go to a like an aftercare home. Like, don't just jump straight on a flight because you may get like blood clots. Like, all these small things, like getting your drainages and getting the massages and like how they have to kind of.
Here's the crazy thing. I'm just gonna compare this to myself because I had a major surgery done in December. a major surgery. It wasn't no BBL and no dumb shit like that. It wasn't like anything like that. It wasn't even, it was slightly cosmetic, but not really. And I don't know anybody on the planet who's had the surgery I have. I don't know anyone personally. Everyone I've told about this procedure is like, what? What the fuck? Oh my God. I didn't have to join a Facebook group to know how to take care of myself leading up to or after. My doctor, my dentist, it was a dental surgery. My dentist was the one who made sure I had all the information that I needed to make sure that I was ready. And even after that, has taken care of me along the way. Why are these girls not seeing that for you to have to join a social club to learn more about how to care for your medical needs is your doctor's fault? And they still paying for it because it's only $3,500, right? They have nothing to compare it to. They're not even, I mean, I wonder if these women are actually even getting consultations from, well, no, because then they know what the standard is.
Sculpted and like kind of rounded, they're, so it won't
I mean,
look like
not even shopping around, because you know, if I'm looking for a coffee cup, I'ma see a range of prices, a range of options. These women are not looking around, and you can tell, because if they were looking around, they wouldn't fall so low to the bottom. When you're looking around, you at least get exposed to the top. You at least get to see the difference between what you might get and what you chose to get. And it's obvious. These are Dollar General girls.
Like boxy, and it's just, it's levels, you know? That's why I said, I don't knock it, but don't skip any steps. Don't skip any steps. So that's my take on the BBL era. But what do y'all think? Do y'all think that the BBL era is kind of coming to an end? Skinny is back in. Ozempic has been in everybody's mouth, and clearly has people in a chokehold. It's like the brand new thing now. And it kind of seemed like it's working for some people. And for some people, they've been having reactions. Like I said, it's always a reaction to everything. So let me know what y'all think. But thank y'all for tuning in with me. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Oh, yeah. And don't forget to follow me on my Instagram, check out my TikTok, and check out my business page. And like I said, I can teach you how to create content just like this right here. Like even this whole little green screen cutout situation, I can teach you that too. Go ahead and check out my website, check out my eBooks. Everything that I can teach you through the phone, I'm telling you, it's in those eBooks. I custom made those eBooks myself. I got the coaching calls on there if you need help with trying to build your page, you're trying to build your views up, whatever it is, I got you, I promise. Go ahead and check it out. But definitely thank you for checking out my video, and until next time.
I let that continue to play on purpose. She deserves that. Thank you for making this content. OMG, that was crazy. Let me see if I can find the, that was crazy. Oh my God. Let me see if I can find the video of Roly from, was it Bad Girls Club? Oh my God. I mean, I guess if people call me Roly, I would definitely think it would be necessary to get some work done too. Whew, shit. Let me see if I can find something. Oh, is it free? I ain't got my glasses on. Hold on. Let me see. Hold on. Wait, we got movie money in the bucket.
Now I have my pamper out. Oh, Raina, it hurt.
The last movie we watched together happened to be free. So we didn't have to pay for that. I did go ahead and watch They Live. I did go ahead and I think I bought it. I'll be honest, from my purview, from my worldview, They Live really look to me like a movie about white people who are scared of losing their power. And all these colored people all of a sudden having equality. That's what it looked like to me. Because all the zombies were Mexican. you saw like this white laced blonde hair, blue eyed guy going through the world seeing all this truth, and all the zombies are Mexican. Oh my God, it was crazy. We still need to watch that movie together, but it seemed like it was very like all the observed truth stuff was just for us to buy in to the idea. Because if you look at that movie from a non-white person's eyes, then you see the disparity in color in the cast. Just like if you ever watch The Purge from a black person's eyes, you'll see that you never see white people get killed on camera. They don't have blood or nothing, especially in that one Purge, I think it was 3, the one with the girls that had like the roller derby look. You noticed that. It became very, very clear to me what that movie was about. Therefore, I stopped watching those series because it really became clear to me that The Purge was about, it was a white black thing. It was really about getting rid of all the colors. And that's what it looked like they live was to me. I really let that movie, I'm gonna let it play. I watched it. I waited for something to be different. And it really seemed to me like you got this blonde hair, blue eyed, Aryan race who's afraid that equality is gonna ruin their lives. Well, I live in Arizona, so I experience their fear every day. They have a tough time with it. I don't give a fuck. So crazy. I can't put that comment on screen, Douglas, but it tickled me. I live in Arizona, and my family history is on my mother's side is in California, going back to the 1500s. And as far as we know, I am Mexican. My mother's side of the family is from California. They weren't slaves. They are Native American. My father's father is from Oklahoma. He's Osage Indian and Irish. I still haven't been able to trace my lineage back to slavery. I have a great great grandmother named Mama Jenny, who I thought was a slave because she was 9 when slavery ended. But she used to always say, just because I was around for slavery doesn't mean I was a slave. I mean, she wasn't. She was a Native American as well. So far as I'm concerned, I am Mexican, and I be telling them motherfuckers when I go too. I got the same thick neck, same broad shoulders, same little round head as my maids at the hotel. Okay. But anyway, thanks for taking me off topic for that. Let's get into this shit right here. Because apparently this is somebody's review. Let me see if I can find something that's a little bit less me and more them. Let's see. I might not be able to. Let's see. I wonder if I could find the Zeus footage. This is just a teaser, but it might take us somewhere. Let's check this out.
So I'm gonna start injecting some deep numbing medicine now, okay? You're gonna feel some burning and pressure.
This is gonna be uncomfortable.
Don't push
out.
I'm happy with myself being a plus size girl. You know, I could still be that, but with a healthier result.
Ms. Rowley today is a 52 BMI. You're gonna see her continue her journey with gold.
You're doing phenomenal.
We're not talking about milk. We're trying to actually make you feel healthier.
Yeah.
I'm very proud of you.
I know. Hide your men, hide your husbands, because my hair's stealing everybody, nigga, also.
The surgery is nothing.
Oh, my God.
It's the aftercare that give you your results.
Listen, I'm professional as fuck. Bitch, I'll make you lose this whole motherfucking building, bitch.
Big girls all around the world, don't let nobody stop your motherfucking shine.
Let me see if I can find it. Y'all want to get into it? Oh, I did see something earlier. I know some of y'all can.
We all invented.